No matter where you look in the world for petroglyphs, we are always confronted with the humanoid figure with raised arms and in the squatting position, as ancient earthlings tried so hard to reach through the ages to deliver a message of a worldwide event in the sky and in the form of the squatter man. This is the representation of the greatest energy levels observed for the high energy aurora event in prehistory. In Norway, we are confronted by this again at a petroglyph site known as the Bigby Man. We see this aurora phenomenon in the apparent humanoid form because, of course, our brain is telling us that this is nothing but an abstract etching of an ancient earthling doing the hula hoop. This is until we link an ancient catastrophe like an immense plasmatic aurora event with laboratory evidence that overwhelmingly shows us that this is in fact the representation of an event in the sky and one in which ancient earthlings all across the world went to great lengths to document. They left this message for us to find in a language that would be realized, and of course, only now are we making the connection from the abstract to the reality. Viewed in cross-section, the so-called Bigby Man is now visible to the observer as two dots or circles, and literally looks like a person hula hooping, with the bottom squatter man showing the apparent hula hoop now as two dots in a different stage of development. To the observer, the bright plasma column, the amount of plasma viewed in an edge on view, will be the brightest portion and will appear to be emanating from two circles. When the squatter man arms in the upward position, prominent, and takes on the appearance of rings or horns, this upper circular structure could be the result of a prominent outer rim of the polar cusp. The Norway Tourism Board suggests these petroglyphs were created just after the last ice age, around 12,000 years ago, but the current knowledge of such estimates does in fact need serious reconsideration, as our timeline of past events is all over the place. Norway is not in any way as aware of its prehistoric monuments, stone circles, and other ancient sites. For example, in the UK, there is great interest for sites such as Stonehenge and the Standing Stones of Stennis in Scotland, both locally and internationally, with thousands of tourists visiting every year, not even realizing what they are looking at, but being drawn there anyway. But very few travel to explore the Hunfelt or Bygdefelt and similar sites in Norway. Even parts of the local population remain in the dark about their region's hidden treasures. And of course, the world is in the dark about what these are really representing. Time to light that up, and the truth of what they are being more spectacular than any stick figure abstract explanation anyway, and this has been constantly regurgitated for ages. Officially described as ships, sun wheels, and animals, as well as cupular descriptions carved into the rock, these are a great representation of a sky event as witnessed by the observers directly and then carved onto the rock, with the observer again having a clear view of the magnetic south pole, where the event was emanating synchrotron radiation and X-rays in a thunderous column of plasmatic aurora that would have been clearly visible for millennia and responsible for these efforts all across the world to document what was happening. The knowledge was lost, but thanks to research of Anthony Perrat, we are starting to reawaken to what we once knew to be true. In Norway, rock art has been found at more than 1,100 sites, with many motifs occur regularly across the region, and the design and composition of even the most common motifs vary hugely in different parts of the country, according to both the era and function of the particular site. Their view of the sky and the exact time in history the etchings were carved, if we can track down what caused the event, then perhaps we can trace this all the way back to the date when these petroglyphs may have been made. What is millions of years ago, or right around the last ice age, as the Norwegian Tourist Board suggests? The Bigby petroglyphs were painted red so that the modern visitors are able to see and enjoy them. The paint only highlights them. However, even though the stone carvings are visible, it does not mean their meanings and symbolic value is equally clear, and the local tour guides will tell you as much. Rather than trying to set about with a glorious narrative, they simply say that the carvings depict different variations of ships, human squatter men, wagons, and symbols. Although some of the carvings are easier to make out, for example, the ships, it is not clear what stories they try to tell, and the many symbols of different character or even more mysterious as their meaning is still unknown, though some believe them to be linked to the sun and fertility worship. Because of this, the petroglyphs have been important in trying to figure out the myths and ceremonies connected to agriculture, harvesting, and fertility in ancient Norway, and the original meaning that seems lost to history. Another mystery surrounding the carvings is how they were made. Archaeologists have not yet been able to discover what types of tools were used by the ancient inhabitants of Østfold to create this magnificent stone art in Norway. What the tourism board describes as ships with people on board are actually pretty common in the petroglyph record. And of course, we refer to Norway as home of the Vikings, and the pattern of the ship carved into the rock art becomes apparent. But in the petroglyph record, they are actually known as rakes. Rakes are the series of vertical lines, either straight or wavy, and they are usually interpreted as rain. However, what they probably represent is what we normally see as Birkeland curtains of aurora in the ancient prehistoric skies of our planet, and occasionally they are attached to other features, which give valuable clues to their valuable meaning, which evolved into the modern times, keeping an attachment to the ancient meaning with the lost references to the actual event. The images are often combined to form scenes and expressive compositions of the ancient aurora event of prehistory. These rock carvings are an art treasure and an invaluable part of Europe's prehistorical cultural heritage, and we intend to begin to document these petroglyphs here on the Lost History Channel so that our subscribers can better understand what it is that they are representing. We will be back just shortly with more Lost History for you guys to tantalize your thoughts over. In the meantime, remember to give us a thumbs up and subscribe with notifications turned on if you are yet to do so. And remember, the ways by which we arrive at knowledge are hardly less wonderful than the discovery of these things themselves.